Hello everyone and welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today I'll be showing you how to add physics to hair in Blender. I'll be showing you how to add in the particle system, use the soft body simulation to get the icosphere to move around. And yeah, so let's get started with this cube. I'm going to scale it down by pressing S, Z, make it a little bit smaller, probably around there. Then I'll go S, X and scale it along the X. What I want is for the echosphere to hit one of these cubes and then fall down onto another cube and then finally fall down onto the floor. So go into front view by pressing 1 on your number pad, then you can press 5 to go into orthographic view. I'll rotate it this way so it has like this sort of angle. I'll place it right about here, then I'll press Shift D, I'll move it here, and I'll rotate it up. Probably there looks good, and that is probably a good angle. Maybe scale it along the X just a little bit. I did that by pressing S, X, X twice, so it goes along the normal X. All right, next add in the plane. So press Shift A, go to Mesh, and then Plane. I'll drag it underneath, and then I'll scale it up. Perfect. Now let's add in the icosphere. So press Shift A, go to Mesh, and then Icosphere. The reason why I'm using an icosphere and not a UV sphere is because the soft body simulation will act very differently with these two meshes. So I'm going to scale it down just a little bit and place it right here above this cube. Next, go over to the physics panel and click on soft body. Before we get into the settings, I want to make sure all of these objects have a collision modifier so that the icosphere will actually interact with them. So select this one and go collision. Next, select this one, collision, then select the plane and collision. Let's play this and see what it looks like. You'll notice that the echosphere is not moving. That's because soft body goal is turned on. So what we need to do is turn that off. That basically pins the vertices in place. So I don't want any pinning, so I'll turn that off. Now, if we restart the animation, press Alt A to play it, you can see it collapses. Okay, what we need to do now is open up the soft body edges and mess with some settings over here. The bending, this is just how much the icosphere will bend. I'm going to set that value to 1. Actually, let's go 0.9. The push and pull, these are just like the pulling of the mesh and how much it resists to being crushed. We'll set both of those to 0.6. Now, if we press Alt A, you'll notice that it's not getting crushed, but it's still staying in place. The reason for that is because on the collision object, the outer is set to 0.02, so it's kind of morphing into each other and it's not working very well. So we need to make sure that there's a bigger boundary between these two objects. So for the outer, I'm going to set that to 0.1. I will do the same for this object right here, so you can right click on it, set it to 0.1. And I think the plane will be fine. We'll see what it looks like though. You can see it's bouncing quite a bit once it gets past. Goes down and hits that. All right, that looks good. One thing that I want to do though is the soft body dampening. It is bouncing a little bit too much, so I'm gonna set this value to 0.5. That will just kind of slow down the bounciness. I'll do the same for this one right here, set it to 0.5. And then finally, the plane, we'll set that to 0.5. We'll play this and see what it looks like. You can see the bounciness is not as much and it looks a lot better. Good. One more object that we're going to add into the scene before we do the particle system is a cube just over here, so the icosphere will just hit it and kind of stop right around here. So I'll press Shift A, go to cube, make sure it's in line. Yep. Go into front view, press S, X, scale it down a little bit and place it right here. And maybe I'll go S, Y and just scale it out. You can add a collision to that, set the outer to 0.1 just in case. And I think we're good to go. So let's play this one more time, see what it looks like, and then we'll set the particle system up. You can see it bounces, and then it hits and stops right about there. Perfect. Okay, so right click on it. Let's go over to the particle system and click new. Change the type from emitter to hair. And then here is where we set the hair length. So I'll zoom in and I'll set it probably a little bit low, maybe 0.3. Somewhere around there. Make sure advanced is turned on. That might be a little bit long, so maybe I will go with 0.25. I think that'll be good. Okay, next what you're gonna wanna do is scroll down to the hair dynamics. All you have to do is turn this on. We can open this up and see the settings. Now, if we play this, you'll notice that the hair has physics and it's moving around. That's pretty cool. Now over here on the right, we have a bunch of different settings. The mass, basically that controls how heavy the hair will be. We can leave that at 0.3. The stiffness right here controls how stiff the hair will be. I'm gonna turn that up just a little bit. And for the random stiffness, this will just give it some variation. I'll set that to 1. The dampening, basically what that does is it will slow down the hair's bending motion. You can see it right there. So if your hair is like flying everywhere all over the place and you don't want that, you can turn this value up and it will kind of slow down that movement. I'm gonna leave it though at 0.5, that's perfectly fine. The quality, you can turn this up if you want to. I'm just gonna leave it at 5. Okay, let's play this and see what it looks like now with those settings. There we go, not too bad. You can see it's moving around, it's looking pretty cool. Okay, so let's zoom in here a little bit, and the number of particles, we're gonna be setting that value to 2000. And you might notice that there's still a ton of space on the echosphere that we can actually see it, the hair is not covering it. We're gonna go down to the children section and add a lot more hair this way. So scroll down all the way to the bottom and you'll notice a children panel. All you have to do is turn it to simple, and then that adds a bunch of children. And what the children does is it will take one particle and then multiply that by the number that you set here. The display in the 3D viewport is set to 10, but in the render, there'll be 100 particles for every one particle. Okay, for these settings, I'm gonna turn the clump down just a little bit so the hair kind of clumps together. I'm going to set up the randomness just a little bit. We might give the uniform, bring that up just a tiny bit as well. I think that'll be good. Turn on B-spline, and this will just kind of smooth out your hair. I'll set it to 4. You can also open up the display and set the steps to maybe 4 as well. This will just kind of smooth it out, because if I zoom in here, set it to like 1, you can see it's very choppy, but if I go 4, it's a lot more smooth. Okay, so now if we play this, it's gonna go quite a bit slower, but it will look a lot better since there's a lot more hair. And you might notice that what happened right there, that little, like, oh, let's see if we can find that frame. This, sometimes this happens. It's just, I think it's a bug, and what you need to do to fix it is just kind of change a setting or something like that. We'll scroll up maybe, and we'll play that one more time. Maybe it'll fix it. Nope. Okay, I think I have fixed it. So what I did is I just changed the steps over here to a value of 7, and that seemed to do the trick. So make sure if you're having that issue, just turn up the quality and it will be fine. Okay, so now what we're going to do is go over to the physics panel and bake in the soft body cache, and then we'll bake in the particle system. So open up the cache, we can leave the end frame at 250, and all we have to do is click on bake all dynamics, and that will grab the particle system, also the soft body simulation, and bake it all in. So I'm going to pause the video until this is done. Okay, the baking has finished and this is our result. I'll play it. It is going a little bit slow because there is a lot of particles that it has to simulate. But as you can see, there are no visible errors or anything like that. There's no hair flying out into everywhere, and it looks pretty good. Like I said before, if you have an error where the hair just flies out, make sure to change the steps to 7 or anything higher, and maybe bring down the stiffness or bring up. I did a little bit of changes. I brought the randomness to 0.8, and that seemed to fix it as well, and the mass to 0.2. Okay, so now that we've done that, we can now set up the lighting and the rendering for our scene. So for the materials, I'm just gonna right-click on this cube and go over to the material tab, click on use nodes, and set this to the principled shader. We can leave the default settings. I'll also right-click on this one, give it that same material, yep. For the wall right here, I'll also give it that same material. Then finally, the plane here, I'll give it that same one right there. Perfect. The next material that we're going to be doing is the echosphere, so you can select it, then go new. We can change the surface to principled right here, and then for the roughness we can bring that up just a little bit, and you can set the color to whatever you want. Maybe we can go red, sort of like a kind of color like that. Let's zoom in and press Shift Z to see how it looks. Not too bad. What you can do if you want, I'm not going to do it in this tutorial, but you can add a new material by hitting that plus sign and then click new, and you can use that for the hair. So you can have the echosphere be a different color than the hair if you want to. What you need to do then is scroll down to the render section in the particle system and change it to the material that you want. But for now, I'm just going to leave it at material 002. One more thing though that I just realized that I forgot to do earlier is we need to set the thickness of the hair. Because currently, if we zoom in, you'll notice that the hair looks very thick. It's almost like there are little spikes sticking out of it. So go over to the particle system and scroll down all the way to the cycle settings down here. The root, this is where the thickness is in the hair. So we're going to set this value to 0.2, and that will make the hair look a lot thinner and I think a lot better. There we go. Also, you can hit smooth shading on that icosphere so it just smooths it out. Great. Okay, so now for the lighting, I'm going to go to the world settings and bring this up to a white color. Probably around there, I think will be good. I'll press Shift Z, make sure everything looks good. Yes, it does. Not too bad. Okay, next we're going to set up the camera. So I'll probably position the camera right about here by hitting Control Alt 0. Then you can right click on it and drag it into place. I'll set a keyframe on this, so I'll hit I and go location rotation on frame one. Next, we'll scroll through here, probably around to 100. I'll bring this down, then hit I location rotation. So over 100 frames, it will follow the icosphere just like that. And then once it goes down, I'll probably position it right about here and go I location rotation. Let's see if it follows it perfectly. So I'll press Alt A. Actually, I'll just kind of zoom in here because it's going a little bit slow. Don't worry about the particle system. That's just because I jump forward. We'll go through and it looks good. Okay, so now we're ready to do the render. Go over to the render settings and we'll set some settings up here. For the resolution, I'm going to set that to 1280 by 720 with 100%. Then I'll scroll down to the sampling section and I'll set this value to 30. I'll set the indirect to a value of 1. And I think if we open up the light paths, we can turn off those two settings, reflective and refractive. Before I render, I want to make sure that denoising is on in the render layers panel. So to do this, go over to this render layer panel right here and check on denoising. That's all you have to do. Now we are ready to render. Next, we're going to set the output section. So what you need to do is create a folder wherever you want on your computer and set that to here. So once you've done that, you can hit that little button on the side, navigate to where your folder is that you created. Mine is right here, it's just an empty folder, then click accept. Now we are ready to do a render. So save your project by hitting Control S. I'll just save it to my desktop and I'll call it hair. And then all you have to do is click animation and it will grab every single 250 frames and put them in that folder. And then once it's done, we can sequence it out. The reason we're doing that instead of changing this to a movie file is because we can stop the render anytime and then resume it at that point. If you uncheck overwrite right here, if you stop the animation or stop the render, I mean, and resume it will not overwrite those current frames in that folder. So now I'm going to pause the video once again until this is done. Okay, the render has finished, and now I'll be showing you how to sequence it out and put it into a movie file. To do this, go down here and click on Video Sequence Editor. Make sure you're on Frame Run and go Add, Image, and then navigate to where your folder is. Mine is right here underneath Pix. I'm gonna select everything and go Add Image Strip. Next, come over here and change this to a movie file. I'm going to go with MPEG, the encoding, I'm going to go MP4. You can do whatever file that you want. And after you've done that, click animation and it will grab all of those frames and put them into a file. To view the render, you can go up to render and click on play rendered animation, or you can see the shortcut Control F11. Once you do that, a window will pop up and we'll be able to view it. So there you go, guys. That is how you add physics to hair in Blender. Thank you for watching, and make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more tutorials, and I'll see you guys in the next video.